Now we covered how to use the filter pane. We also covered how to use the dashboard level filters, but there's actually another way that you can get to your insights by just clicking on the dashboard itself. Now it doesn't matter if it's a line graph, a bar chart, a donut chart, a pie chart, a table, a matrix. It does not matter. If you click on any point or any row or any selection, the dashboard itself will automatically filter to whatever you just selected. Now let's try this with our donut chart here. If we select Xbox as our product category, you'll notice that the whole chart has been filtered to only Xbox and grayed out Power Platform and Office 365. And if we go to the other visuals, you'll notice that the product category is only being selected to Xbox as well. Now we can verify this in a few different ways, but at high level, you can see that when we selected Xbox on the donut chart, it's spitting out 213K of net sales. And if we verify that against our KPI card in the top left of 213K sales, that's working. And also in the table in our bottom right, you can see the net sales 213K. Now, in order to unselect something on-page filtering, just go back to the selection you previously clicked, click it again, and that'll bring the dashboard back to default. We can also do multiple selections on the on-page filtering method by just holding down Control and hitting with your mouse the selections that you'd like to make. So let's go ahead and try that with Power Platform and Xbox. I'm gonna hold down Control, press click on Power Platform. I'm gonna go ahead and grab Xbox too. Now, the other way we can validate that the on-page filtering is working is that we can go to our visual here. And remember, we can go to our filters on all visuals, little icon with the three lines, and see what is impacting that visual. And you can see from our on-page filter that our Power Platform and Xbox product category filter is impacting both of those visuals. Let's test this on the line chart you see here. Since the line chart is being aggregated by net sales and by date, when we click on a certain point, let's say May 19th, if we click on the point of May 19th, that will filter all of our net sales data to only that point in time. So what you're seeing now is our whole dashboard filtered to only May 19th. Now, what I recommend to all my users is to not use this method unless you're doing really quick insights. The filtering pane or the dashboard level filters or whatever the Power BI developer has given is the best route for slicing and dicing your data. And really it is common practice to use that because it gets less convoluted and less confusing and you know exactly how your data is being cut.